State Senate filibuster.
That's my point here. Essentially, is that the state of American politics is a fucking joke. Okay? It's a reality show, basically, with little personal attacks and no substance. This bill is proof of that. So I've been up here for the last 19 hours filibustering against it. Because if this... this bill... Tea party. Into getting this bill, SR-42, passed into law. I'm not really sure what SR-42 is, but when I found out that the definition of a filibuster is that a group of senators can hold the floor for as long as they want and talk about anything that they want, well, I said hell yeah, because as many of you know, I, Senator Jimmy Valentine, how you doing? I've been in the news a lot recently about alleged dealings with a supposed Russian lady. I'm sure you've all read some facts on the supposed internet. And I'm here to tell you the truth. I'm here to make a confession. The fact is that I'm innocent and I haven't been allowed to tell my side of the story yet. Okay? And if politics has taught me anything, it's that just writing a speech or an editorial is for squares and losers, and I haven't been elected for 4 terms now by being a square or a loser. What Americans want to see is not some lame PowerPoint presentation.
Hey!
It's a full-on rock and roll musical. For the last 58 hours, I've been locked in my Senate chambers, living off candy corn and sugar-free Red Bull. I've written a script and some songs on GarageBand. And right now, I'm gonna call down some other senators, and we're gonna do a musical right here on the Senate floor during this filibuster, and we're going to explain to everyone on national television the circumstances of my current scandal. Now, for my actors, can I first get the junior senator from my home state to come on down here, a brilliant man and a disabled American, an inspiration to handicapped people all over this country, Senator Dan Daniels.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Of course. Well, and then moving on, of course.
I knew you'd pick me. I knew you'd pick me. It was fate.
Well, I knew you'd be a good sport. And you begged me, so.
I know we haven't had a lot of face-to-face time since I was elected as your deputy senator.
No, it's junior senator. It's not deputy. And the reason we haven't spoken in 2 years is because you were only elected because your opponent died on a casino boat the day before the election. That man was my father.
I know, but I just really, really want to reiterate, I care so much about this. This means the world to me. You're my idol. I grew up idolizing you my whole life. You're the reason I got into politics. When I saw the way you lived with all the girls and the money...
Daniels! Don't screw this up for me.
No.
All right. Now, for my actress, my ingenue, can I please get that minx on the Appropriations Committee, Senator Carly Feingold? Senator Feingold, come on down here. Oh, my God.
You son of a bitch. I'll do it, but not for you, for us, okay?
I don't know what you're talking about, Carly. I'm in the middle of a sex scandal right now.
Well, frankly, I don't know what you're talking about, saying you just left your tie in my dorm room.
It was 1982, and I was hammered. No, actually, I'm not saying that. It's not my tie. It could be anybody's tie. Just don't do this now, Carly, you psycho.
But it wasn't anybody's tie. It was your tie. And it was more than a tie. It was a promise. Because we're two young, attractive, ambitious people have too much planner's punch. It's only a matter of
time. Oh, my God. No. That's it. Okay. Senator Feingold, we're trying to exonerate my character, and you are not helping.
I don't see how musical's gonna help, Jimmy.
How?
Because everyone loves musicals. Earlier today, I was on the phone with a celebrity friend, Mr. Paul Reumann, and we were discussing Rock of Ages.
Folks, that's Pee Wee Herman. And I had an epiphany, the likes of which I've only had one other time when I finished this great collection of American short fiction. I put down my box of wheat thins and I started typing. Because what is the only true American art form?
Jazz.
Hip hop.
Flash mobs.
A baseball
bat. Macaroni.
Clouds.
Reality pornography.
What? No. It's the musical. It's the purest American thing one can do. It's an exemplar of patriotism. It's both enlightening and entertaining. It's the perfect medium to explain my perspective.
Hi, everyone. I mean specifically websites like MILF Hunter or Bang Bus, which every American has visited at some point. It's not just me.
Thank you, Senator. When the British soldiers were marching on Lexington and Concord, Americans didn't just pray over a Bible and then just go to fight.
No, they made the slaves and peasants do it.
No, they marched with their fifes and their drums. They marched singing in the pageantry of war. Lincoln wasn't shot at a deposition or a speech. Lincoln was shot at a play.
They didn't have movies back then. So you couldn't have been at a movie.
When FDR was in the Great Depression, he didn't say, well, fuck it, I can't walk. He made a cameo in the musical Annie. The musical's in our blood. It's the only thing Americans truly respond to.
It's in any history book you open up. Just look on any...
Shut up! Nixon's biggest mistake wasn't Watergate. It was Watergate the musical. Because he never did it. The only way for a politician to be seen as truly innocent of his crimes is to cast himself as the ingenue in a play of politics.
Hi, everyone. When I said reality pornography, I just meant, like, when it's two guys fooling around with their camera, and they go to the mall, and they pick up a girl, and they bring her back to their van and bang her until she can't walk anymore. But it turns out she's actually a porn star in disguise the whole time. That's what I'm talking about. So for you to act like you don't know what I'm talking about is completely absurd. And I would appreciate if you didn't do that anymore. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. And also, I'm going to prove a little point today. I'm going to go Mandela on y'all a little bit. Reach across the aisle. Maybe this senator, maybe we disagree on healthcare, gun control, and abortion. Heck, maybe we even have different opinions about the critically and commercially successful Graceland album by Paul Simon. Maybe I hate his guts. But maybe Arnold Sneed has the best baritone voice in Congress. Senator Arnold Sneed, come on down here!
Woo! Be part of my music!
Now stop! Stop it! This is absurd! Just stop this! Now, I refuse to be a part of this charade. This bill must pass.
Well, it's your choice, Sneed, but I wouldn't want to let slip what I saw happening in the Capitol Building gym last Wednesday. Oh, have I said too much?
You shut your mouth, Valentine. And Paul Simon is an autistic colonialist who's only usurped a rich tradition of African culture for commercial ends.
All right. Well, folks, it looks like old Arnie Sneed won't play along.
So let's begin. Our play opens in the sauna of the Capitol Building gym last Wednesday morning around 10:30 a.m.
Okay. I'll do your stupid little play. But there's to be no more talk of that situation.
All right. Your scripts are highlighted, and the music is ready. I'm off book.
How did this get in my suit pocket?
No. Now join me as we take a ride through the tumultuous past few weeks that have been my life. What really happened with that young Russian woman who married me and then immediately died? Was a purple heart, just like great grandpa before. He and I are not the same, because now I screwed up. I made a mistake. What more do you want from me? I went on the Today Show and SNL. I apologized on TMZ. What was the truth has now been twisted so much it's become a lie. I wouldn't buy a Russian hooker, I'm just not that kind of guy. I've made mistakes, but don't press charges, there must be some other way. I'm a family man at heart, I never meant to go astray. My wife was dead, so lonely I tried to replicate her loving kisses with a foreign teenage bride. And when that one died, it was not my fault. Valentine is not the guy that you should blame. If you had seen what I'd seen, I swear to God, you would have all reacted just the same. The doctors and eyewitnesses and policemen, they all lied. I swear that he won't see the same if you let me tell my side. It really wasn't that bad. It's me. I'm the victim. The people don't believe me, 'cause the media has tricked them. Valentine's your guy. He's here when you need him. If you don't hear me out, then you don't believe in freedom.
We open in a hospital waiting room. Senator Jimmy Valentine is doing push-ups, yet he admits no body odor or sweat. His breath is minty fresh. His penis is above average in size, much larger than Senator Arnold Sneed's microwave. Now that's a medical condition.
Message for Valentine.
Yes?
Well, which one of you is Valentine?
Well, I'm Senator Jimmy Valentine.
And my name is Arena, but at work, I go by the name Valentine Deluxe.
You know, if we ever got married, you'd be known as Valentine Valentine.
Who says you wouldn't take my name, Sailor? I'd make you Jimmy Deluxe. Ha 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 ha.
No. She's doing accents, I'm doing accents too. Like Mary Poppins.
Okay, fine. Just stick to the script, right?
All right. Dear Valentine, why, I'm sorry, you are in the hospital.
Well, that note could still be for both of us.
I am also sorry about your botched abortion, but I'm not paying for a thing.
Hey, we get it. It's for Irene.
Hold on, no. Trust me, that could still definitely be for me. Keep going.
You owe me $15,000, and I'm sending you back to Russia. If you don't give me the money by tomorrow, I'm sending you back in bits and pieces. Nobody messes with Dimitri. Nobody.
Well, it looks like that message is for you.
We established
that. 2 pence for me trouble, Governor.
Oh, no. What am I going to
going to do? I don't have the money. I'm just a poor immigrant with nobody to turn to.
Do you know what I do when I'm in trouble, Arena?
No, what?
I trade political favors or money for it to go away.
That's just it. I need a green card to stay in the country and 15,000 American dollars. Who do I know who is connected and rich and virile enough to do that?
I totally am, but my wife would kill me. That's why I'm here, in fact. She's in the hospital and is very, very sick.
She sounds awful.
Mr. Jimmy Valentine!
Yes? Jamaican doctor?
Jamaican. It appears your wife is up in the sky with Bob Marley, smoking the spliff in the clouds, looking down on me.
Say your line.
Your wife is dead.
Oh. Well, that's great. Now I can platonically marry this young, vulnerable Russian woman, just so she can stay in the country.
That's a great idea, Senator. Here, here's your wife's wedding ring, as well as some extra medicine she hasn't used. A jar of painkillers and some medicinal cocaine.
Thank you, Doctor.
All right, Margaritaville, man. Leave the German. Stir it up, man.
Daniels, just say your next line.
I, as a doctor, have to go attend to Senator Arnold Sneed's anal hemorrhaging in the ER.
Goddamn nation!
Will you really marry me?
Of course I will, Arena. It's the Valentine way. Helping others, I've dedicated my life to it. Plus, this is the perfect way to honor my dead, lovely wife.
I cannot believe you! You gave that Russian whore your dead wife's wedding ring. You didn't even think to ask me? I would have let Ted and a Ted in a second! I hate those kids!
Oh, come on, I can't believe you! They weren't... They're not supposed to know it was a hooker. It was gonna be like a big reveal at the end of the musical.
Jimmy, they all know she was a hooker. It was on the news.
Yeah, but it wasn't in the story yet, you know? It was gonna be like The Usual Suspects when you find out Kevin Spacey was faking that limp the whole time.
Do you mean that Kevin Spacey was Kaiser Soze the whole time?
No. Wait, what? Oh my god, that movie is awesome. Okay, back to the script.
What about the $15,000 I owe Dimitri?
I know, well, I'll get that. I have a massive campaign fund, but I'll be reelected anyway because of my charm and my mom connection. So, why don't I give you some of that?
Isn't that illegal?
No! It's not illegal if you use the money for charity.
You're a modern-day Jesus Christ, Jimmy Valentine. She gives him a big kiss. Oh, boy.
Oh, my God, Carly, no! No, Carly! Carly!
I'm sorry.
It was 1982. We were both in college. We moved on. It was one night, and I'm pretty sure I was passed out.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to get in character, like Raptor hands, wherever he is. Right? I'm staying, okay? And you were passed out!
I'm alone, now my wife is dead. Our union is no more. Where will I find another chick who moves to the couch when I snore? I would ask her, make me waffles, TiVo all my favorite shows. Now the only thing I ask is for her to slowly decompose. She wasn't perfect, that's for sure. She had a wheelbarrow for an ass. But she always tried to placate me with yoga and that spinning class. I'm alone, now my wife is dead. Our halcyon days are done. Of course I know I have a kid, but he's like 9. And not as fun. I mean, he's cool, we play Xbox, and GTA is pretty sweet. But he can't cook, and I don't think that he would be as into feet. Yes, it's true, she'd start a fight when I'd forget her sister's name. But she would ignore my booze, a vice I never overcame. Where did you get my wife's robe?
Yeah, let's go with it!
I'm alone, now my wife is dead, and grieving really blows.
I must be strong and forge ahead and learn how to wash my own clothes.
Now we're in a small motel room. The only reason we're here is so that Senator Valentine can help this poor immigrant. And because the palm was booked. Seriously, folks, have you ever tried to get a reservation there on a Thursday night? It's impossible. Parentheses, wait for laughter, and parentheses.
Ha ha! I wrote you a bad joke! No laughs at all!
It's almost as good as Paul Simon's Majestic Graceland album. From its catchy synth hooks to its haunting African chants and non-linear lyrical narrative about loss and redemption. Oh, come on!
Sauna!
Sauna.
I thought you wouldn't come.
Of course I came, Irina.
Just that so many men have abandoned me in my life. I could kiss you for being so charitable.
No, I cannot kiss you. I love my dead wife too much.
But in Russia, we express gratitude through affection. Please don't disrespect our culture. Also, I have this tie of yours from college. Mm-hmm. You can use during foreplay like you probably did then with the young woman who loves you very much, Jimmy.
Oh, crikey. All right. In the interest of foreign diplomacy, I will accept one blowjob. But please do not kiss me on the mouth in honor of my dead lovely wife. Oh, also, here is the $15,000 I owe you for that unrelated business situation.
My God, Valentine, you wretched man.
Steve, keep it down! This is art!
Sheriff Valentine, you make Chekhov look like a retard.
To the bedrooms! But first, do you think I could have one of your wife's painkillers? I have an awful headache from that operation earlier.
Why, of course, Irina. Have them all. But don't take too many now.
Now, hey, what is that stuff?
Oh, it's prop cocaine.
Prop cocaine, what does that mean?
Well, it's low-quality cocaine.
You can't bring cocaine onto the Senate floor.
Speed! Enough! Okay, I need to know what happens next. Action.
Oh, yes!
Oh, yes.
You know what they're doing in there?
What do you possibly see in him? You're a child.
I love him.
Oh, no, Irina!
Oh, no!
You took too many of those evil pills.
Yes. I love you, Jimmy Valentine. You are a god amongst men and the best lover I ever had. But you must not alert the authorities of my death.
Why not? Let me call you an ambulance.
You cannot, because I am actually a prostitute.
The twist!
And I couldn't risk your political career. My final wish is that you bury my Russian carcass underneath the middle school baseball field.
I'll do it for you, my love.
Also, a man by the name of Senator Arnold Sneed, a frequent user of prostitutes, confided in me that he has gay chlamydia. Now I'm dead.
Now hold on! That is not even a thing! I will not let that slide.
No, really? Well, maybe I'd have to let some other things slide.
You'll pay for this, Valentine.
Whatever, dude. How do you bury a hooker like Irina? How do you drown a corpse and weigh it?
Okay, stop! Stop that! Stop the music!
What the hell? Why aren't
you in your cop costume? Who the hell is this guy? Does he even know the choreography? And where are the sparkly batons? I spent hours making those.
Listen, asshole. He's a real cop.
Double twist!
I called him as soon as you implicated yourself in the embezzling of campaign funds. You've been under investigation for months, and all we needed was one last piece of the money trail before we arrested you for charges of conspiracy, money laundering, treason, bribery, possession of narcotics, and the solicitation of prostitutes.
Don't make me say what happened in the sauna, Arnie.
We have copies of your bank statements and signed confessions from your accountant and campaign finance advisor.
Arnie, don't do anything stupid.
Child Services is at your house right now, removing your son and placing him under protective custody.
Arnie, don't force my hand.
That's it! I shit myself, okay? I was in the sauna last week and I took a nap, and when I woke up, I had shit all over myself, and I tried to cover it up by sweeping it up and putting my poop into the coals of the sauna, but I didn't know that it was an electric heater and not real coals, so I clogged the heater and it short-circuited. Oh God, and now the sauna is off limits and the entire men's locker room smells like my poop because I baked the smell of my poop into the walls of the sauna. There, I said it. I'm not proud, but now everybody knows.
And, officer, may I take this time to mention that Senator Sneed hates Paul Simon's Graceland album?
Diamonds on the Soles of Her Shoes was my wedding song. You're a monster.
So what do you say, officer? Do you mind indulging an old senator in one last crazy dream? And letting me finish my musical?
Well, you're Jimmy Valentine, and we all love you down at the station, but Sarge says I gotta arrest you. But we do love musicals, too, so okay, sure, why not? Yeah, let's finish.
Thanks, officer! Here's your line.
Oh, great. Okay. But, Mr. Valentine, what about the 14 other women who came forward and said you attacked them? How can you explain them?
That's a very simple explanation. For years, I was systematically targeted and raped by a series of young Russian maids who blackmailed me and later turned out to be prostitutes.
Now that's ridiculous.
Yeah, what is it?
Wait! You haven't heard the song yet.
Those slippers raped me. I am innocent. A big conspiracy. Russian immigrants. I'm the victim here. It's pretty clear that things are not what they appear. Those hookers raped me for forgotten me. A lonely senator in Washington, D.C. It started years ago when I arrived in town. At first I just said no, but then I came around. Each with a sob story, I couldn't turn away. I felt like I was Maury, crying every day.
5, 6, 7, 8!
You raped me, I am innocent. I was not a John. They screwed me to say thanks.
Yeah.
check out that. Take classes here. It's magnettheater.com. So, yeah.
And if you don't want to see that show, which I'm sure is really good, we are going to go down to the Triple Crown bar and